Hey, it is Rich here, coming at you from the heat of the garret here at Tedium Towers. Got a bit of a video Inception vid going on here. I'm going to be expanding on a vid made by Dan over at the World of Mr. Grey, in which he expanded on a comment that I left on one of his previous vids. Is that right? Anyway, go over and check out the mighty Dan Delph with his fucking devilishly handsome good looks and sexy Welsh accent. You don't twatty make it easy for the rest of us, do you, mate? I'll put a link to his channel down in the description. If he's Dan Delph the Grey, would that make me more Rich Tar the Blue? In Dan's original vid, he's discussing how a number of paranormal channels have confessed to staging paranormal activity in some of their vids. Paranormal channels faking vids. Really? What a surprise. To which I left the comment, should monetized channels who've been caught faking real paranormal vids be charged with fraud? Which then prompted Dan to make this vid as a follow-up. There are a great number of points brought up within the vid and in the comments, but I feel that some see it as a bit of a grey area, whereas I think it's more cut and dried than that. The analogy of going to the movies and reading fantasy novels has arisen in the comments of both vids, but I see it like this. Unless you're specifically going to see a documentary film, then the implication is, when you walk through into the cinema, that what you're going to see is a complete work of fiction. Hell, that's what escapism's all about, ain't it? Plus the fact movies include statements like this in the end credits. Similarly, when you walk into the fancy fiction sci-fi section of a bookshop or navigate to that section on their website, you already know that anything that you read within the pages of the books isn't actually real. But these monetized channels with thousands of subscribers post vids stating things like 100% real ghost activity with no such openness or explicit disclaimers as to the legitimacy of the content, while they are deliberately being deceptive. Also that the money from YouTube, Patreon supporters, merch sales, even directly into PayPal accounts keeps rolling in. That right there, that's the very definition of ill-gotten gains, and is tantamount to fraud. Nor does it matter that we can't legally prove whether ghosts do or don't exist. That's not the fundamental issue here. The issue is that these channels are stating that the so-called evidence they're presenting within their vids is 100% fact, true and real proof of ghosts, when it's clearly been proven otherwise, to the point where these channels have had to come clean and admit they've been faking, and that's an admission of guilt. This'll not bother some of the subscriber base on these channels, nor am I suggesting that all of their subscribers believe what they're watching in these vids is real. They're most likely watching just for the pure spooky creepy value, which is fine. But this does, however, bolster my belief that people truly don't care about the pursuit as to whether ghosts are real or not. They just want to be entertained. But I'd wager that a goodly portion of these channels' subscribers do believe in ghosts, and that the evidence that they're presenting within these vids is real. And it's these people these channels have outright conned. The solution to all of this? I don't know. I've got ideas, but that's for further debate. If you want to get deeper into this discussion and other topics relating to the current state of the paranormal community, then please consider joining Paranormal Tedium's Facebook group, Paranormal TRUTH. We've created a safe haven free from the usual ridicule and aggression normally associated with discussing the truth about the paranormal, and where we can finally get to the bottom of things together with open and honest debate. Links to the Paranormal TRUTH group and Paranormal Tedium's Facebook page are down in the video description. Steve and I hope you'll join us there. If you can't be arsed with that, then just let us know your thoughts on this subject down in the comments. Now, I'm not hating on these channels or the individuals that have created them, but I do think they're morally suspect when it comes to the truth about the paranormal. With that said, please consider subscribing to the channel and remember to click the bell icon. Thanks for watching.